they were screwing everything up, you know? I mean, look, they had an opportunity to dominate streaming media. They also owned, at the same time, the patent to cost per click.
Yeah.
Right? Now, Google's entire business to this day is built around pay-per-click, rather, not cost per click, pay-per-click. Yeah. So they had the entire patent for pay-per-click. Had they just said, sorry, Google, you can't use it, there would be no Google. Instead, they said, yeah, $133 million and give us some stock. They were just too nice, right? Which blinded them in a lot of respects. And I remember walking in with a $32 million sale, saying, okay, we're gonna do streaming, we're gonna sell all this company's content, you know, it's worth $32 million for us, and it's gonna preempt these other potential competitors. And I forget if it was Jerry or Tim or whoever said, no, we don't work that way. We don't preempt competition. We just leave it open. I'm like, okay, it's time for me to go buy a basketball team. they just didn't see these things. And I mean, it's a lesson in your businesses. There's gonna be, everybody's always trying to kick your ass. And you have to figure out how to kick your own ass first. Seriously, because if you're not brutally honest with yourself and your own business about what your frailties are, someone else is going to find them. Yahoo didn't get that. Yahoo just thought, you know what, we're just going to continue moving forward and then we'll just compete with everybody else and, you know, we have no other problems. Didn't quite work out for him, did it?
No, it did not.
Michelle Obama in 2018, she gave a really, really great quote and I live with it and I think about it all the time. And I want to get it right because y'all niggas be in these comments ready to cry, especially over. Yeah. Anyways, I have been at every powerful table you can think of. They are not that smart. This is an example of that. I'm gonna break down how Yahoo blew $140 billion. Stay locked in. My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pond. My name is Dorian from group82music.com, and right here, we got Mark Cuban talking about how Yahoo blew $140 billion. For those of y'all that don't know, I'm gonna give you a little bit of a recap. Mark Cuban is a billionaire. He went to IU, shout out IU. He became a billionaire through his company, broadcast.com. They were essentially the first streaming company. And Mark Cuban and his partner, Todd Wagner, sold the company to Yahoo, I think for like $6 billion or something like that, 5.7. I can't remember the exact amount, which made Mark Cuban a billionaire. He went and bought a plane. He went and bought the Mavericks. Now he's on Shark Tank, doing all that cool shit. At the time, the internet was still basically a baby. This is the late 90s, early 2000s. And people were using the internet, but it's not like how it is today. People weren't shopping on the internet. They weren't dating on the internet like Tinder. Well, they were, but it was some weird like Dungeons and Dragons basement nerd type shit. People wasn't watching porn on the internet. People wasn't making money or investing really in the internet like that. It was still very, very early. A lot of folks were skeptical. But Yahoo had the patent for essentially trillions of dollars of internet money, and they just gave it away. Cost per click. Cost per click is when an ad is on a website, you click the ad, you pay the website, you pay the creator. It's pretty much that simple. So for example, if y'all watch this on YouTube right now, I'm gonna have ads in this video. When you click the ads in this video, I'm going to get paid for that because you clicked the ad. Cost per click. The advertiser is going to pay a certain amount based on the amount of clicks on the ads on my videos, so you know what you need to do when you see them joints. With that said, that is literally how Facebook makes all of their money. 98% of their money comes from advertising revenue. I think 60 to 70% of Google's money comes from advertising revenue. And Yahoo had the patent on this shit. And at Yahoo's peak, their market capitalization. Market capitalization is the amount of shares that are publicly available multiplied by the stock price at that current moment to equal the market capitalization. The market capitalization for Yahoo in 2000 was $140 billion. Go look at what that shit is today. They completely tricked this shit off because they didn't have that fire. In every industry, y'all heard me talk about this, there are gaps. Gaps in every fucking industry. I'm in the music industry, I'm in entrepreneurship, finance, whatever the hell you wanna call me at this point, and there are gaps in everything that I do. When I was talking about the music business nonstop, I saw there was a gap of someone who was black, who was a rapper, who talked like how all of us talk, who was of the culture, who was smart in business, independent, getting their music streamed, getting their albums bought, and was building a brand on their own and was teaching people. I filled the fucking gap. It changed my life. Yahoo had the number one gap of the internet. How to make money from traffic on the internet, cost per click, and they just gave that shit away. Gave it away. Google's entire business model, thank you. Facebook's entire business model, thank you. Go look at the market cap of Google and Facebook today and go look at what Yahoo's worth, like I told you to do before. When you have something, there's nothing wrong with teaching people, but you need to own that shit. Yahoo gave away their masters, and look at them. This is why you don't give away that shit. You can teach people, you can license it out, you can lease it out, but you don't sign that shit away. You don't just give it away. Because you want open, fair competition. Life is open, fair competition. All of us came out of our daddy's balls. And we had to beat 300 million of our twin brothers and sisters to our mama's egg. And we won. We won. We're winners from day one. Competition is in us. And you want to give that shit away? The fuck is wrong with you? These people are not that smart. So when I say shit like Lil Wayne's master's going to be worth $1 trillion, this is why. Nobody could envision that Facebook and Google will be making this much money from advertisement 21, 22 years ago, but they are. So where are we gonna be 50, 60, 70 years from now? It's why you gotta own. It's why you can't be putting your career and your life's desires in the hands of other people. They don't get it. They don't understand. They won't market your music like how you will. They won't mix your music like how you will. They won't promote your business like how you will. They won't cook those cakes the way you will. They won't design that t-shirt the way you will. They won't recruit for that life insurance company the way you will. They won't sell that house, realtor, the way you will. They won't design that workout program, fitness instructor, the way you will. You gotta do the shit yourself, man. And we are in the era of self-sufficiency. If you want to do things yourself, you're going to get paid. I'm living proof of it. So either you want this shit or you don't. So what do you want to do? Do you want to be like Yahoo? Or do you want to be like Google? I know which one I want to be. And ain't no fuck ass Yahoo. If you somebody want to be like Google, you need help, you on Instagram, click the link up top. You on YouTube, click the link in the box. Mouth the pond. Y'all stay true. Hey, hold up before we leave. Make sure y'all click that like button. Y'all niggas don't be clicking that like. I need them likes. Helps the algorithm. Make sure you subscribe too. Not the pop. Y'all stay tuned.
Getting buckets every corner. Filling pockets every owner. Fetty's coming at the donors. Killing like a Michael Porter. Getting buckets every corner.
Hoop82music.com.